Infrastructure, including bridges, roads, water supply systems, crops and trees, was destroyed in the mudslides.
The roads are now blocked with some stones. So it means other programs of the government, we are not going to access them. So those are the fears actually we have as Kitulu sub-county local government.
Residents say heavy rains pounded the area for over 5 hours, offsetting soil and causing it to roll downhill.
Any time such an incident can happen. So that is why we are informing our people to be ready for those disasters. If you have children and maybe you have somewhere to go, you can at least put them in a safe area.
A woman who survived with injuries is admitted at Wera Hospital, but in stable condition. I survived narrowly. Although I'm steadily improving, I am still feeling some pain. Ernest Kazimoto, a resident in the area, said most of the plantations and property were destroyed. They have nothing to eat.
It has swept everything, especially the eucalyptus trees, crops like beans, banana plants, coffee, avocado trees, among others, even cassava. So we are really shedding tears.
That when we are trying to till our gardens, we need to use some terraces, put some ditches in our gardens, in order that when rain comes or when water is overflowing, then our water will be just resting in those ditches.
The district senior planner, Mr. Joseph Isingoma, warned people to be careful in the month of May, saying most rivers have started to experience an increase in water volumes.
We must be very careful with the month of May, like it has started showing us. We should prepare enough, and one of the things that we should really be doing right now is embarking on creating clear way through for the running water. Those are drainage channels, especially in our communities.
In 2020, 8 people died in floods and mudslides that hit parts of Kitulu sub-county on the border with the Democratic Republic of Congo after River Taku burst its banks. Story by Gilbert Mwanguzi for the news.